For some people, the buzzing of bees can send a shiver down the spine. For experts in agriculture, it's a symphony, especially now, when honeybees continue to die at an alarming rate.
Millions of hives have been lost, and the real value of the bees is crop pollination in our country and in Europe.
Honeybees help pollinate about one-third of our food supply, including many favorite fruits and vegetables. Here's another way to look at it. 100 crops provide 90% of the world's food, and more than 70 are pollinated by bees.
You wouldn't have an apple if the bees weren't there when the apple tree was blooming. I mean, you really have to move that pollen from tree to tree. So, and bees are the key to that.
That's why researchers like Dr. Jeffrey Pettis are trying to unlock the mystery of colony collapse disorder, or CCD. Since 2006, seemingly healthy bees have abandoned their hives and never returned. Researchers estimate nearly one-third of all honeybee colonies in the U.S. have disappeared.
So the fruits and vegetables have a bit higher value, both monetarily and I think nutritionally, than do rice, corn, and wheat. I mean, those are staples. They'll keep you alive. You can survive on staples, but you can't thrive. You can thrive on those other fruits and vegetables and nuts.
Wild blueberries from the state of Maine depend on honeybees. Without their pollinating travels, you can scratch the number one antioxidant fruit in the world off the menu. As the state apiarist, Tony Jadzak oversees Maine's beekeeping operations.
We brought in roughly 65,000 hives this year from all over the United States to pollinate the wild blueberry crop.
Commercial beekeepers truck their bees all over the country. These particular bees, which are pollinating the blueberry crop in Maine, came here from Florida. And prior to that, they were pollinating the almond crop in California. After they're done here in Maine, they head down to Massachusetts to pollinate cranberries. All that moving around has some wondering if this extra stress is a part of CCD.
You'd think it would cause some stress, and I'm sure it does, but it's not. Doesn't seem to be a major driver of what we're seeing. Those beekeepers who are stationary, don't move their colonies, are suffering the same losses as the migratory beekeepers.
So are researchers closer to finding a cause for this disorder? One recent study by a Swiss researcher suggests cell phone signals could be the problem. Pettis, who is one of the leaders in the U.S. research effort, disagrees. He says while his team has uncovered evidence to rule out that and other potential causes, they have not found the smoking gun.
Initially, we were looking for that one pathogen or that one new virus that we thought might be the cause. And so far to date, we haven't found that.
Pettis and other scientists instead focus on what he calls the three P's: poor nutrition, pesticides, and pathogens. Here is one of several labs at the federal government's bee research laboratory. It's known as the Bee Disease Diagnostic Lab. Samples from all over the country come here from beekeepers wanting to know what killed my hive. The scientists will look at the bee samples and determine if there are any parasites or diseases. One suspect, the vicious varroa mite.
Not only is it literally sucking the blood out of the adult bees and the developing bees, but the mite is also a vector of various viruses.
As researchers search for the cause of colony collapse disorder, they encourage beekeepers to concentrate on the health of the bees they do have.
So when they're in times of the year or in an area where they think there's not enough pollen coming in, beekeepers are feeding extra protein, and that seems to help, seems to produce healthier colonies.
And that can lead to healthier diets and a healthier economy. Workers at Wyman's in Maine know this all too well.
Well, with $15 billion worth of produce that's pollinated by bees annually, you know, everybody is going to have something on their dinner table that is pollinated through honeybees.
The country's leading grower, packer, and marketer of wild blueberries has taken a hit because of CCD. Senior manager Darren Hammond says pollination costs have gone up around 35%.
I think that the cost of beekeeping and the cost of renting bees is going to continue to increase over time.
Still, Hammond says Wyman's is pressing on, providing grants to universities for CCD research. Scientists and researchers appreciate the funding, and Pettis says he also welcomes divine intervention in solving the mystery.
We'll take all the help we can get.
Mark Martin, CBN News, Beltsville, Maryland, and Washington County, Maine.